And now we're at the Roseville Family Practice. It's a UNC Rex Healthcare facility, and I have with me Dr. Benton, who is our main doctor here. She has a PA, Sharon Johnson. We'll probably meet her in a little while, but we've got a few questions for Dr. Benton, and I think what we want to do is inform you that Rex and UNC is here to stay. Okay, Dr. Benton, can you explain all of the services that you're now providing for our Roseville residents?
Sure, yeah. Here at Roseville Family Practice, we provide the full spectrum of family medicine. So we see ages 6 and up. We take all major insurances, we take Medicaid, we take Medicare, and we can provide sick visits and acute visits. A lot of times we can get you in on the same day, so just give us a call, that's not a problem. But we also love doing preventative care. So we do well child checks, adult physicals, vaccines. I also have a lot of experience doing GYN or female care, so we can provide those. And I also love doing in-office procedures, so we can do some basic skin procedures, check out moles that are changing, doing abscesses, toenail removals, that type of thing.
Oh, that's great.
Yeah.
Okay. And like I said, we want to get across to the people that Rex and UNC is here to stay. So, you know, I think as I was leaving, there was a bunch of UNC and Rex people going out the door to come to visit. So we're so glad to have you because it's something that we want a stable practice in. And UNC and Rex has provided a great health care thing for all of North Carolina and especially the Raleigh and Triangle area.
Right. Yeah, I think Roseville's really lucky to have a UNC Rex owned practice here because they're definitely here to stay. And of course, it's a statewide healthcare system that provides really, a great quality of care. We have access to the UNC specialists when we need them. And, we are really in touch with them. We're able to communicate with them and have them provide services to our patients here too. So this, I think, will definitely be a very stable practice with a lot of resources to help the Roseville community.
Yeah. All right, how do people get in contact with you?
Right, so our office is located right in the heart of Roseville. We're on Southtown Circle. And we have a website, RosevilleFamily.com, so you can log on there, find out about myself, find out about our office hours and the services that we provide, and also download some new patient forms. And our phone number is 919-554-9412. And so you can call our office. We're open between 8 and 5, Monday through Friday. And we do offer answering services well after hours.
Great. If I needed to schedule an appointment?
The best thing to do would be to call our office, and our front desk staff will be happy to get you in right away.
Okay, thank you. I want to introduce Sharon Johnson, who is the PA here. And I was just talking to her, and she's got a very interesting background. She did her undergrad, I guess, at Austin College. On an athletic scholarship. Tell us all the things you did.
Well, besides being pre-med, I ran cross country in the fall, played women's ice hockey in the winter, and ran track and field in the spring.
So we have a very athletic PA here in Roseville. So all of you sports-minded folks may want to come see her. But we've been talking to Dr. Benton, and we wanted to introduce you and let them know that you're here and that I guess you basically furnish the same thing as Dr. Benton. PA is almost the same thing as a medical doctor. She just has to, I think you have to have their sign off or something, right? Explain PA to me.
Sure. Yeah. As a physician assistant, I see patients on a daily basis by myself. Although if I have questions, I certainly have Dr. Benton's expertise here to, talk with her about a more complex case.
Sure.
I write prescriptions. I sign my own prescriptions. I make referrals. I order tests and interpret tests. So a lot of what I do is the same as what Dr. Benton does, and including seeing my own patients. So I actually have patients sign up just to see me, just like she does. So we work really a lot together here in the office, and You know, overall, I just don't have as much education as her. Obviously, she has a bachelor's degree and a four-year medical school degree, along with her residency, but I have a bachelor's degree and a two-year master's degree to become a PA. So I get out of school a little bit faster, but I don't get paid, you know, as much as she does, but I pretty much do the same things that she's doing. But the nice thing is I work, you know, with her directly if I have any problems.
Yeah, I can understand. I know in my earlier career with the state, the state health plan, the physicians I went to, I actually had a PA for about 6 years, and I never knew the difference. So, well, we just wanted to introduce you, and it's nice to have you here in Roseville.
Thank you. I'm glad to be here.
Okay.
Thanks.
Here we are today with Jenny, the owner of the Flower Creations in Roseville. It's our only florist, and we're proud of it. Jenny,
hello.
I'm glad to have you
hello.
On the Mayor's Show. And we just want you to tell us your business hours and basic thing, your telephone number, how to get in touch with you.
Okay.
If you've got a website, that too. And then we'll just let you go around and kind of show us all the offerings you have here.
Okay. I'm Jenny Kelton, and I own Flower Creations Florist here in Roseville. We're located at 412 South Town Circle. That's right off of South Main in the Commons Shopping Center. My phone number here is 919-556-5696. And you can reach me during business hours, Tuesday through Fridays. It's about 9:30 till about 5 or whenever the last customer leaves. And on Saturdays from about 9:30 till about 2:30 or thereabouts. On Sundays and Mondays, I also can be reached with my cell, 919-671-9671. And that is for, you know, if you need a special occasion, all of a sudden, a funeral, a wedding, whatever. But I'm more than, I'm available to meet your needs on those days as well.
Okay, thank you. Yeah, sounds very good. Yeah. How about just going around now and showing us everything you offer? I mean, it's amazing. I see seasonal and I see other plant, live plants and other things and wreaths and things like that. So just, I'll just let you walk around and explain it to us.
Okay, great. We are a full service florist, and by that I mean we offer fresh flowers, silk flowers, dish gardens, wreaths, seasonal wreaths, funeral flowers, wedding flowers, all occasion flowers, just what if flowers, okay? And also I do outdoor pots, custom made for folks to put outside front doors or where have you. We also belong to three major wire services, FTD, BloomNet, and Flower Shop Network. So you can also reach me that way. My websites, I have two websites, both you can Google Flower Creations and they'll come up for you. But this is one of my pride and glories right here. This is, of course, a big flower urn and a glass top table, but if you look inside, there's actually growing plants inside.
Oh, there's plants in here, yeah.
It's a terrarium, and it's been potted like that for, well, ever since I opened my doors, February 2.5 years ago. Of course, we have little potted plants. If you want just a little potted plant in a dish or something other, we have, you know, neat little things that can be given as small gifts. We also have designer-type vases, if you would like to put a little bit something more into it, that are made out of really good crystal. Then you come on around a little bit. This is a seasonal wreath right here with the red sunflowers and so forth. If I turn it around, this is another seasonal wreath that's different colors, different colors, but they're again very seasonal. Okay, and this is a larger seasonal, fall seasonal wreath, okay? Now if you look back here, I also do the teddy bears. I also have a few quilts on hand to sell if you would like something like that. This is where I keep all my vases. We have everyday vases like these little ones, or everybody will recognize one like this. But we also have a fine selection of really nice crystal, heavy lead crystal type vases if you want a keepsake. Of course, my cooler over here, I always keep it as well stocked as I possibly can. I may not have the exact flower you need that particular day, but I can always get what you'd like. As I said, we're a full service florist, and by that we do offer a full array of funeral flowers. These right here are ready-made to go on tombstones or at tombstones to help remember your loved ones. We also have the arrangements that go on top of a tombstone itself. This is some examples of some of the types of potted plants that we have. I always keep on hand various sizes of dish gardens and peace lilies and so forth. I usually have bigger peace lilies, but they've already gone out of the shop today. And of course, a silk arrangement up here if you need something for your dining room table. Okay? And as an example of a really nice, nice floral arrangement, we made this one up today. This has like 24 roses in it, red, yellow, and then the mixed color roses that are really kind of neat. So, and it's a Vera Wang designer vase. So it's in a really nice crystal vase. But we can do something very expensive like this, or we can go all the way down to one single rose in a vase, whatever you require. And just to let you know that I do have a sense of humor, this is a wreath I made up a few weeks ago. I saw these items at a wholesale store and I just had to have them. And anyway, this is my fish wreath. This is Willie Trezell, and he has been a real godsend to me. He has many years of experience working for another florist. And he came to me just before Valentine's Day this past year. And he is a wonderful designer. And we work well together. And if I'm not here, you can always talk with Willie.
So what are you working on right now, Willie?
This is called Curler Willer. And I'm just stripping the leaves off of it. Some that we use in our artificial flowers.
I wanted to also let everyone know that I do offer fruit baskets and gourmet or chocolate baskets as well. And these might include a fruit basket, of course, would be apples and oranges and maybe whatever else is in season that's really a nice fruit. And it's all wrapped up in a basket with a big bow tied on top. A gourmet basket could include fruit, but a lot of times it doesn't. It may be all cookies and crackers, specialty cookies and crackers, different mustards, preserves that you don't normally get, good things that you don't normally just go to the grocery store and buy. And that there again, it's in a basket and it's all wrapped up real pretty. And like one today, I did today, wish I still had it, but it went out, is all chocolates. Everything was covered in chocolate. We had chocolate peanuts, we had chocolate truffles, we had all sorts of kind of different things covered in different flavors of chocolate. So any kind of gift basket you may wish, we can put one together and have it delivered.
Well, Jenny, I want to thank you for giving us a tour of your florist.
Well, thank you.
And of course, we want to let everybody know in Roseville, we got a florist, so let's shop Roseville.
Thank you very much.
All right.
Appreciate it.
Bye.
I usually start about 3:30 in the afternoon, and I have to, I get water and stuff from my house and get their food. I gather all their food up. I go up and I start, I feed four different colonies. So I start at one location and just go all around to all the different colonies. And then I usually am back home about 6 o'clock. So it's a pretty drawn out process, but the cats that I feed in the colonies also, they are kind of tame because they've been seeing me for like 4 years. And it's a pretty costly thing to feed them every day. I use about 3 bags of cat chow a week and, you know, numerous cans of food, of course. My cats that I feed are for the most part pretty tame. I can pick most of them up and hold them, and I can pet just about every single one of them. So that's why it takes me a little bit longer every day, because I try to provide them with a little bit of love anyway. Okay, cat colonies they consist of what people consider feral, which would be wild cats. These cats could have been born in the wild, or they could have been actually left in a colony by their owner. I have had quite a few, I call them drop-offs, at one of the colonies in particular that I feed, because people will ride by and see the other cats and see the colony and think, well, I really can't afford to feed my cat anymore, so that looks like a good place for them. I'll just take them up there and leave them because it looks like somebody's feeding them. That is not a good idea at any time. A lot of people will bring cats and leave them out by dumpsters because they think, well, they can find something to eat. Not a good idea. If you cannot afford it, don't leave them somewhere like that or beside the road. Just take them to a shelter somewhere. I mean, it's just not a good life. It's not. And then you just depend on people to feed them for you. And that's one of the reasons that I feed the cats, is because it keeps them out of people's yards. It keeps them from trying to find food elsewhere. And the way that you can tell if a cat has been spayed or neutered, usually, is their ear will be clipped on the end. And if you see a cat that's ears clipped on the end, you can probably assume that it's been fixed, it's had shots. And by shots, I mean rabies, distemper, regular shots that cats get. And so you would not have to worry about it being rabid. I try to make it as simple as possible. I give them Purina Cat Chow. Whenever I get wet food for them, it's usually the bigger cans of Friskies or Nine Lives. I try to keep them on the same thing all the time, because outside cats are prone to parasites and other things that already cause their digestive system to be, you know, kind of sensitive. And so I feel like if they eat the same thing all the time, at least that would not be an issue for them. You can send your donations to 502 Southtown Circle in Roseville, North Carolina, to the town hall. Actually, they ask if you would put my name on it. They would, Janet Wall. They would make sure that I got the donations. And also, I would like to say that any sizable donation, if you would like a tax deductible receipt, I would be glad to supply you with one. And as I said, Purina Cat Chow or Friskies or Nine Lives wet food is great. Or anything, gift certificates, anything that'll buy food or any food, I'll take it. The organization that has been spaying and neutering these cats is Operation Catnip. If you have a cat that has taken up at your house or somewhere in the vicinity of your home, and you would like to keep it there or not, you can call Operation Catnip, or you can visit their website, operationcatnip.com, and there's several people there that would be glad to talk to you about spaying and neutering the animal. And these services that they provide, they have a monthly clinic on the third Sunday of every month. They normally send somebody out or will bring you traps to trap the cats, take them into Operation Catnip, get them fixed. There are also very many vets in the area that take the vouchers that they provide. Low-cost vouchers are available for those that can afford them, and those that cannot fill out applications and just go through a very simple process. And they let them have the vouchers. The Roseville Veterinary Hospital takes the vouchers. There's a clinic in Zebulon, I believe, that takes the vouchers. There are several clinics around that take the vouchers. So if you have a feral cat, or if you find a feral cat and want to make it your cat, please call somebody at Operation Catnip. They will help you get the cat spayed or neutered so that you control the pet population. It's not, a feral cat life is usually shorter than most cats because of the elements that they live in. So I would just ask that, you know, if you could find room in your heart, if you do find a feral cat, give it a home.